Hello everyone, my name is Vipul Sangma and I'm going to teach the subject mathematics of class 10. Hope all of you are doing well and fine. Today the topic I have selected is written here, introduction to trigonometry. The word trigonometry indicates the first three things, tri, the three letters, tri, tri means three. Then you have G-O-N-O, this indicates angle, and the last five letters, that is metry, that indicates measurement. So trigonometry is, the meaning of the word trigonometry is true angle measurement. I have selected this topic because it finds a wider application in higher mathematics. This trigonometry, if you learn, then some certain things you can measure it. Like suppose there is a big tree, then you have a pond. After that, this is the land part. You want to know the height of the tree, how much it is. Then by standing at the bank of the pond, you can measure the height of the tree if you know trigonometry. Likewise, you can apply this trigonometry in other fields as well, like to drop food grains with the help of a helicopter or with the help of a plane in the correct location, at what distance you'll have to release the food grains so that it reaches to the right spot. That also you can measure with the help of this subject or this topic, trigonometry. So to know this trigonometry chapter, you'll have to learn the six trigonometric ratios. They are sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant, and cotangent. These are the six trigonometric ratios you'll have to know, but they are abbreviated. Sine is abbreviated as S-I-N, but you still pronounce it as sine. Cosine is abbreviated as cos. Tangent is abbreviated as tan. Cosecant is abbreviated as cosec. Secant is abbreviated as sec. And cotangent is abbreviated as cot. But if we write sine, cos, tan, cosec, sec, cot, we cannot define them. To define them fully, we need to put an angle here, then only we can define it. The angle, you can use it as capital letter A, B, C, D, anything you like. Suppose I have written A here. You can use Greek alphabets like theta, you can use psi, you can use phi. So these are the letters that we can use to indicate the angle. The moment we put an angle, then it can be defined. Suppose let me take this angle as theta. This letter, we call it as theta. If I take this as theta, then they can be defined distinctly. So let us first define what is sine theta. Sine theta, to define, is defined in a right angle triangle. In a right angle triangle, one of the measurement of the angle is 90 degrees. Here I have taken angle B as 90 degrees. Then the other two are less than 90 degrees, so they are called the acute angles. This acute angle is theta. You can place it at angle A or you can place it at angle C, that is your wish. Suppose I'm placing this angle at this vertex C, I'm taking it as theta. Then this side AB will be called as the opposite side, or we call it as perpendicular. Perpendicular side. Then opposite of 90 degrees, as you all know, that This is AC. It is called the hypotenuse. I'm writing in short as HYP, hypotenuse. And then the line that is adjacent to this angle theta, we call it as adjacent side, or we call it as base. So to define sine theta, it is the ratio between the perpendicular side, that is AB, to its hypotenuse AC, that is AB by AC, AB by AC. Cos theta, it is defined as the ratio between adjacent side to its hypotenuse, that is BC by AC, BC by AC. Tan theta, it is defined as the ratio between perpendicular or opposite side to its adjacent side, that is AB by BC, AB by BC. And the other three, they are reciprocal of each other. Cosec theta, it is the reciprocal of sine theta, so it is hypotenuse to its perpendicular. Your hypotenuse is AC, it's a reciprocal, AC by AB. Then sec theta is the reciprocal of cos theta, that is AC by BC. And cot theta is the reciprocal of tan theta, that is BC by AB. So to remember this formula, you can use a shorthand notation and write down one sentence. Some people have curly black hair turned permanently brown. If you know this sentence, then you can remember the formula very easy way. If you take the first letter of each word, S, P, H, that means the sine theta S, it is perpendicular by its hypotenuse. H indicates hypotenuse. Then you have the second one, that is cos theta, is base by hypotenuse. Cos theta is base by hypotenuse. And then the third one, that is tan theta, T indicates tan theta, it is perpendicular by base. This is perpendicular by base. And the other three, as I have already said, sine and cosecant, they are reciprocal of each other. Sine and cosec. Cos and sec, they are reciprocal of each other. And cotangent, tan and cotangent, they are reciprocal of each other. So if you know these three, then the others you can make it out. Cosec theta, you write it as hypotenuse by perpendicular. Sec theta, you can write it as hypotenuse by base. Cot theta, the reciprocal of tan theta, so it is base by perpendicular. So this forms the basis of trigonometry, the basic thing that you have to know. And with that, you can start doing the exercises. So let us see one question I'll solve and show to you. I'm writing one question here. If sine A, suppose it is 3 by 4, or say 3 by 5, calculate cos A and tan A. Like this, you'll get your questions. So what you'll have to do is, first you'll have to check this acute angle A, you'll draw one right angle triangle. Acute angle is given as A, so I'll write here A, this is your angle given to you. In B and C, as you like, you can choose it. Let me take C as 90 degree here. Then you write down, or you start solving like this. Let ABC be a right angle triangle. Right angle that C and right angle at C, the equidangle is A, so no need to mention here. You can see here this equidangle is A. So from your formula, you know that this is your perpendicular, this is your base, and this is your hypotenuse. So from the given value, that is sine A, it is 3/5. So you write down the given value, then you remember your formula. Sine is defined as perpendicular to its hypotenuse. So it is BC by AB. So you write in place of sine A, BC by AB is equal to 3/5. And as the value is given in ratio form, you write down, therefore, BC is equal to 3K. On constant time, you take it. And AB is equal to 5K. Why we take this constant term? The reason is that in ratio form, suppose my age is to my son's age is 1:2. As an example, it's given as 1:2. It does not mean that my age is 2 years and my son's age is 1 year. To know the exact values, suppose here 1, if I multiply by 20, then it's 2 into 20. Then the exact ages, this ratio of this constant terms must be same. This is 20:40. The exact ages will be 20, and 20 into 2 is 40. Like that, whenever ratio values are given, it's necessary that you take one constant term, and that constant term here I'm taking it as K. After knowing these values, suppose perpendicular is 3K and hypotenuse is 5K, by using Pythagoras theorem, you can find out the third side in the right triangle, that is AC. So you proceed like this, in right triangle ABC, by Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus perpendicular square. So hypotenuse square, here you have 5K, and base is to find out, that is AC, and perpendicular square is 3K. So here we'll get 25K square equal to AC square plus 9K square. Let us calculate it. 25k square minus this plus term, you can bring it towards your left, minus 9k square, it is equal to AC square. By transposition, you can bring from right to left, plus will change to minus. This 16k square is equal to AC square. So AC will be square, if you remove it, here square root of 16k square. Root over 16 is 4, because 4 square is 16, root over k square is k. Like that, you can find out the third side. After you find out the third side, that is 4k AC, now you can find out the, you can look the question, it is mentioned, find cos A. So cos A, you can find out like this, use your formula, that is base by hypotenuse. Then you can see your base is 4k, hypotenuse is 5k. This is 4k, hypotenuse is 5k. So you'll get 4/5. This kk you can cancel it out. And then it's asked to find out 10a. 10a, 10 is defined as perpendicular by base. You can use your formula. perpendicular here is 3k and the base is 4k. So it is 3k by 4k, it will give you 3 by 4. Like this, you can solve the exercise questions. One more, I want to do and show you one more question. Consider a right triangle ABC. Right angle at C. In which AB is 29 centimeter, BC is 21 centimeter, and angle ABC is theta. Calculate cos square theta plus sine square theta, say. This is your question. Then you'll have to follow up the question. You're asked to consider a right triangle ABC. So you'll draw one right angle triangle ABC. Right angle at C. So 90 degrees at C. In which AB is 29 centimeter. That means you can take A and B as you wish. Now here it's mentioned ABC, angle ABC is theta. ABC is theta. If this is B, this angle B, ABC, it is given as theta. AB is 29 centimeter. Hypotenuse is given 29 centimeter. BC is given 21 centimeter. Then you are asked to calculate cos square theta plus sin square theta. If you look the question, you will understand that these two sides are given and this is missing. So I can use Pythagoras theorem to find out the third side. So do the solution like this here. In right triangle ABC, by Pythagoras theorem, your hypotenuse square, so equal to base square plus perpendicular square, and as I said before, opposite of this angle we call it as perpendicular. Opposite of 90 is always hypotenuse. Hypotenuse will never change. And BC, that is your base. So by looking here, you can place the values. Here hypotenuse square, you can see 29 square. Base square is 21 square. Perpendicular is AC, we need to find out AC square. So here 29 square minus 21 square plus, this value is minus on transposition, that is equal to AC square. So you can use your identity and can solve it. When the number becomes big, you can use your identity, that is A square minus B square. You have learned from class 7 onwards, A plus B into A minus B. Whenever number becomes big, you can use your identity like this. Then here when you add it, you'll get 50. And here if you subtract it, you'll get 8. Then 8 into 50, you'll have 400. So AC will be square, if you remove it, you put square root. And square root of 400 is 20. 20 into 20 is 400. Like this, you can find out the perpendicular, that is AC. After you find out this, then you can go for calculation of cos square theta plus sin square theta. Now, cos square theta plus sin square theta, that will be equal to cos is defined as base to its hypotenuse. So BC by AB, it is BC by AB, square is there, don't forget. Sin theta is perpendicular by hypotenuse, it is AC by AB, AC by AB is also whole square. Then put the values, BC, you can see it is 21, by AB, it is 29, plus AC, sorry, sin theta is perpendicular to its hypotenuse, 20 by 29. This is 20 by 29 square. 21 square is 441. Then 29 square, you can calculate it. 81. Plus 20 into 20 is 400. 29 square is 841. Then you can take LCM. 841, your LCM will be 841. 841, one time is 841, so it will be 441. Plus, here also the same thing with LCM, so it will be 400. So you will get here on addition 841 by 841 will give you 1. So the value of cos square theta plus sin square theta in this given question is 1. So I am going to give you an assignment, one question I will give, you can try and see at home. You can note down the question, this is your home assignment. If 3 cot A is equal to 4, check whether one minus tan square A by 1 plus tan square A is equal to cos square A minus sin square A. Cos square A minus sin square A. So children, don't get confused. Here 3 cot A, then how I'm going to solve? Before the sir has not done like that question, you may be thinking that way. But I'll show you how to do. 3 cot A is equal to 4, so simply the given thing is cot A is equal to 4 by this cross multiply and bring down here 3. So cot A will become 4 by 3. Then as I have solved, you can also follow up. And here you have to do LHS, RHS. What the values you look, if both are equal, then they're equal. Not equal, then you mark it as not equal. Thank you and have a nice day. Stay safe.